वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक फोर्थ सेम सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क. माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ अवर टॉपिक इंटरनेट वर्किंग. वी हैव नो दैट और वी अज्यूम दैट देयर इज अ सिंगल होमोजीनियस नेटवर्क एंड विथ विच मशीन्स यूजिंग द सेम प्रोटोकॉल in each layer, but unfortunately this assumption is widely optimistic and many different networks exist, including PAN, LAN, mains and WANs, and we have described internet over cables, the fixed and mobile telephone networks, then wireless standards 802.11, 802.16 and more. And numerous protocols are in widespread use across this network in every layer, and so we will look at the issues that arise when two or more networks are connected to form an internet work, and more simply as an internet. And it would be much simpler to join networks together if everyone used a single networking technology, and it is often the case that there is a dominant kind of network such as Ethernet, and some of the persons group of people speculate that the multiplicity of technologies will go away as soon as everyone realizes how wonderful is and do not count on it, and history shows that it is to be wishful thinking, and different kinds of network grapple with different problems. So for example, Ethernet and satellite networks are always likely to differ, and reusing existing systems such as running data networks on top of the cable, the telephone network and power lines, and adds constraint that cause the features of the network to diverge, and heterogeneity is more important here. So if there will always be different networks, it would be simpler if we did not need to interconnect them. This also is unlikely, the value of a network with n nodes is the number of connections that may be made between the nodes, n to the power 2, and this means that large networks are much more valuable than small networks because they allow many more connections. So there always be an incentive to combine smaller networks. So the internet is a prime example of these interconnections, and the purpose of joining all this network is to allow users on any of them to communicate with users on all other ones. When you pay an ISP for internet service, you may be charged depending on the bandwidth of your line, but what you are really paying for is the ability to exchange a packet with any other host that is also connected to the internet. And since networks often differ in important ways, getting packets from one network to another is not always so easy. So how networks differ? So networks can differ in many ways. Some of the differences, such as different modulation techniques or frame formats, are internal to the physical and data link layers, and these differences are not so important, but here you can see in figure some of the many ways network can differ: service offered, addressing, broadcasting, packet size, ordering and many others. So here are some of the differences that can be exposed to the network layer, and it is papering over these differences that makes internet networking more difficult than operating within a single network. So when a packet sends by a source on one network must transmit transist one or more foreign networks before reaching the destination network, many problems can occur at the interface between networks. And to start with, the source node is to be able to address the destination, and so what we do if the source is on an Ethernet network and the destination is on a WiMAX network. So assume we can even specify WiMAX destination from an Ethernet network, and packets would across from a connectionless network to a connection oriented one, and this may require that a new connections be set up and on short notice, and which injects a delay and much overhead if the connections is not used for many more packets, and many specific differences may have to be accommodated as well. So how do we multicast a packet to a group with some members on a network that does not support multicast, and the differing max packet size used by different networks can be a major nuances too, and how do you pass an 8000 byte packet through a network whose maximum size is 1500 bytes, and if packets on a connection oriented network transistor connectionless network, then they may arrive in a different order than they were sent, and that is something the sender likely do not expect, and it might come as an surprise to the receiver as well. So this kind of differences can be papered over with some effort and efforts, and for example, a gateway joining two networks might generate separate packets for each destination in lieu of better network support for multicasting. A large packet might be broken up and sent in pieces and then joined back together. Receivers might buffer packets and deliver them in order, and there are lots of examples related to these differences. So here we will not discuss all these differences. So next one is how networks can be connected. This is the part one for internet working, and we will discuss this few points here. So this is the last point in today's sessions. So how that last topic, how networks can be connected. So after that, we in next video we will discuss more about internet working. So start with here. There are two basic choices for connecting different networks, and we can build devices that transist or convert packets from each kind of network into packets for each other network, or we can try to solve the problem by adding a layer of indirections and building a common layer on top of the different networks. And either different way the device are placed at the boundaries between networks. So early scientists agreed for a common layer to hide the differences of existing networks. This approach has been tremendously successful. At the layer they proposed was eventually separated into TCP and IP protocol, and after that IP is the foundation of the modern internet. So IP provides a universal format that all routers recognize and that can be passed through almost every network, and IP has extended to its reach from computer network to take over the telephone network also, and it also runs on sensor networks and other tiny devices that were once presumed to resource constrained to support it. So that's for this IP, Cerf and Kahan were awarded the 2004 Turing Award, and known as the Nobel Prize of Computer Science for your knowledge. So we have already discussed different devices that connect networks, including repeaters, hubs, switches, bridges, routers and gateways. So repeaters and hub just moves bit from one wire to another, and they are mostly analog devices and do not understand anything about higher layer protocols. Bridges and switches operate at link layer. They cannot be used to build networks and bust only with minor protocol translation in the process. So for example, between 10, 100 and 1000 Mbps internet switches. Interconnection devices that operate at the network layer, namely the routers, and so we will not discuss about other devices. So let's explore at a higher level. Interconnection with a common network layer can be used to interconnect dissimilar networks. An internet comprised of 802.11 MPLS and Ethernet network is shown in figure You can see here figure A, and suppose that the source machine on the 802.11 network wants to send a packet to the destination machine on the Ethernet networks. Since these technologies are different and they are further separated by another kind of network, MPLS, and some added processing is needed at the boundaries between the network. And because different networks may in general have different forms of addressing, the packet carries a network layer address that can identify any host across the three networks. And the first boundary the packet reaches is when it transitions from an 802.11 network to an MPLS network. And 802.11 provides a connectionless service, but MPLS provides a connection oriented service. This means that a virtual circuit must be set up to cross the network. Once the packets had traveled along the virtual circuit, it will reach the Ethernet network. At this boundary, the packet may be too large to be carried. Since 802.11 can work with large frame than Ethernet, to handle this problem, the packet is divided into fragments and each fragment is sent separately. When the fragments reach the destination, they are reassembled and then the packet has completed its journey. So, next, the protocol processing for the journey is shown in figure B. You can see here. The source accepts data from the transport layer and generates a packet with the common network layer header, and which is IP in here example. And the network header contains the ultimate destination address, which is used to determine that the packet should be sent via the first router. So the packet is encapsulated in an 802.11 frame whose destination is the first router and transmitted, and at the router the packet is removed from the frame's data field and 802.11 frame header is discarded. The router now examines the IP address in the packet and looks up this address in its routing table. Based on this address, it decides to send the packet to the second router next. For this part of the path, an MPLS virtual circuit must be established to the second router, and the packet must be encapsulated with MPLS headers that travel this circuit. At the end, the MPLS header is discarded and the network address is again consulted to find the next network layer hop. It is the destination itself, and since the packet is too long to be sent over Ethernet, it is split into two portions. Each of these portions is put into the data field of an Ethernet frame and sent to the Ethernet address of the destination. And at the destination, the Ethernet header is stripped from each of the frames, and then the contents are reassembled and the packets has finally reached its destination. So here you can observe there is an essential difference between the routed case and the switched case. With a router, the packet is extracted from the frame and the network address is in the packet is used for deciding where to send it. With a switch or bridge, the entire frame is transported on the basis of its MAC address. Switching do not have to understand the network layer protocols being used to switch packets, or routers do. So internetworking is not as easy as we have made it sound. And in fact, when bridges were introduced, it was intended that they would join different types of networks, or at least different types of lane. They were do this by translating frames from one lane into frames from another lane. So this did not work well for the same reason that internetworking is difficult. The difference is the features of lanes, such as different maximum packet sizes, lanes with and without priority classes, are hard to mask, and bridges are not prominently used to connect the same kind of networks at the link layer, and the routers connect different networks at the network layer. So internet networking has very successful at building large networks, but it only works when there is a common network layer. So there have been many networks protocols over time, and getting everybody to agree on a single format is difficult. When companies perceive it to their commercial advantage to have a proprietary format and that have that they control, and examples like besides IP, which is now the near universal network protocol, So where IPX, SNA, Apple Talk, and none of these protocols are still in a widespread use, but there will always be other protocols. And the most relevant example now is probably IP version 4 and IP version 6. And while these are both versions of IP, they are not compatible. So this is all about internet networking. And something about router. A router that can handle multiple network protocol is called a multi-protocol router. It must either translate the protocol or leave connections for a higher protocol layer, and neither approaches it entirely satisfactory, and connection at a higher layer. So by using TCP requires that all the network implement TCP, and then it limits usage across the network to applications that use TCP. So that's all about internet networking, and we will study more about internet networking in next video. So all the resources are from our resources from Computer Networks and 5th edition. So session ends here. Thank you.